Hello, fellow Gothamites, and welcome back to my channel. It's been quite some time since the last video, so sorry for that, but I promise I will be producing content now more regularly. So let's dive in what's new and what lies ahead, shall we? So first things first, I refilled my stock, so to speak, with some juicy new minis. I got me some Dynamic Duo from the Batman 60s TV series. Also, the Mad Hatter will enter Gotham soon. I could not resist and bought the Batman Year One Mini 2. Some reinforcements for the Riddler crew. Commissioner Gordon. But I bought it mainly for the Bat-Signal, for using as scenery. Nevertheless, Jim Gordon will definitely reinforce my GCPD crew. And finally, my favorite Batman villain, Two-Face. Gorgeous model. I wasn't quite sure about the base, so I magnetized them so I can switch between games. Never played a game with minis with those huge base sizes yet, so we will see how it will go. The magnets are not super strong and the mini sits not perfectly well, but I don't think that will bother me in games. All in all, I'm happy that Night Models puts two base size options in the boxes for us players to have a choice. I also bought the objective card set, so I don't need to print stuff out anymore. Besides some character cards, of course. And for sure, the Two-Face gang. So I can finally field a complete Two-Face gang in my games. And last but not least, the new starter box back to Gotham to reinforce both my Batman crew and the Joker crew from my wife. And also the markers and tokens will come in handy too. So what's next? I already painted some stuff for my next battle report that will be finished editing soon. Let's take a look at what I and my wife painted. So first I painted the KG Beast. I love that character since its first appearance in the late 80s. In fact, my very first Batman comic was 10 Nights of the Beast. So I was really happy when I saw that Night Models released a KG Beast character. Next one is Harley Quinn from my wife's Joker crew. She wanted to get a different color scheme than that of the box art, and I really dig what she did here. Looks gorgeous. Next one, for my organized crime crew, Carmine the Roman Falcone and Alberto Falcone. Just a teaser for you of what's coming next, because those two will lead my organized crime crew in the next battle report. I accidentally did cut the cigar of Alberto and had to make a new one out of green stuff. Didn't really look like a cigar, but I don't really care. Finally, my wife did some Joker gas containers and painted one of Harley Quinn's hyenas. Okay, so now I will present you my 350 rep organized crime crew that I will use in the next battle report. As I said, Carmine and Alberto Falcone will lead the crew. They hired KGBs to kill on sight and do the dirty work. The rest consists of Iceman with his juicy rifle, Troy Sins, I equipped him with brass knuckles for more punch in close combat, Showtime with his multi-fire automatic gun, The Bull, I equipped him with a backpack maybe that will come in handy, and The Tailor, that will act as my bodyguard for Carmine Falcone. Overall, with Carmine I have more funding to use and all of my henchmen gain the For the Family trait, which is a bodyguard light trait, so to speak. Really useful, I think. Now for the Joker crew of my wife. Leading the crew is, of course, the Joker, in his Arkham Asylum version. Harley Quinn will join him, and she bought the Pole Dancer upgrade, which will give her Escape Artist and will make her even more agile. Next one is Dynamite, just a cheap henchman with a chance to explode when you hit him. Panda Man with an extra ammunition upgrade to get some ranged attack threat. Whiteface, just another cheap dude. Buffon, another cheap dude. And in the middle, Borgon the Cursed, with a mental torture upgrade that will make him a bit more dangerous in melee. Okay, those are the crews for the next battle report. Stay tuned and I hope I will see you in the streets of Gotham when the two gangs will clash. I hope you liked this video. I would like your opinions on the paint jobs and the lists. Leave some comments about how you think who would win and maybe some tips for us too. Stay safe and we will see each other next time when there is still a shadow over Gotham.